Life is a journey made up of experiences, some good, some bad, some happy, some sad. We may all be different, but we are connected through the fact that no matter who we are, our stories all have hills and valleys. So tonight, we dedicate this episode to those who take the long and winding road, only for it to lead them right back to themselves. Welcome to Sim Soul Sessions. Everybody, and welcome to Sim Soul Sessions, where tonight we talk to a young woman who had it all and gave it up just to settle. Really? Well, we invite you to join in tonight's conversation by using the hashtag Sim Soul Sessions. In this session, we talk to my friend Tami Chin Mitchell about her journey of perception versus reality and her finding her imperfections and telling her story of struggle and pain found her a freedom she never knew existed. So Tami, thank you for being here with us tonight. I'm so excited to have you here.
I'm so excited.
Are you nervous?
Yes.
Why?
I'm excited, I'm nervous. I'm just, you know, bringing it back to this moment where we're two friends talking.
I know.
Which is nice.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Here's what else is beautiful. Let's start here. Mm. Let me show you something on the screen.
Okay.
And you tell me a little bit about this hot mama, this young lady who we're going to show you. So, Lori, roll it when you can. And you tell me a little bit about who she is. This was, you were signed to a big label.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking at it now.
Yeah.
I remember the time. And this ought to be, or should have been, like, one of the best times of your life.
Yeah. But and in many regards, it was certainly a lot of fun. And certainly, you know, in many ways, a great time in my life, you know, and I'm so glad that I had that experience.
It was also
a really trying time too, you know, and there's, you know, there's something about something looking shiny and pretty and looking like, you know, the way it should, but then feeling a real like emptiness with it, and you don't really understand why there is this emptiness, why there is this void that you can't really fill. But everybody else says, but you, look at your life. You should be so happy.
Everything
and, you know,
great.
Everything is great. Yeah. You're about to be this and about to be that. And we're expecting this of you. And, you know, and what a hard letdown to deal with, you know. This is the thing about expectations. They are born in other people. You know, we don't create them by ourselves.
You start preach early, Tam. Hold on. Because everybody was looking on and saying, yay, Tami, we're so happy for you.
Yeah.
Signed to this label, your boss will know.
Mm-hmm.
Tami was like,
yeah.
I don't want any of this. Or
no, you know, it was just, I'm a people pleaser, big time, you know? And I say a lot now that, you know, when I started music, it wasn't even because it was this soul calling or this passion, even though there's lots of interviews saying, with me saying, I'm so passionate about this. It was something I could do and something people saw for me and people saying, you would be a great fit for this, so why not try it? So I was like, sure.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, it just started to change. It started to shift on me and I started to discover who I was. And then I started to realize, oh, this is not what I want anymore.
Yeah.
So it's not that it was so, you know, out of line with who I was. For a long time, it was totally aligned with who I was. But I don't think we give people enough credit for shifting and changing and transforming. And that's exactly what happened. You know, and it wasn't the first time I was shifting, changing, or transforming. It's just the first time that I guess people were seeing it.
But it's not only the shift and the change and the transformation. It's, again, back to the expectations.
Yeah.
She's leaving music to do
To do what? Yeah.
And what was it that you wanted to do?
I wanted to be a wife and a mom.
Shock crazy and child. What was the sentiment at the time when you decided, I'm not doing this, I'm walking away from the shiny?
Yeah.
I just want to be...
I just didn't really tell many people at the time, you know, because I knew that it wouldn't come with a lot of support. I was supported by who needed to support me, you know? But I understood that people generally wouldn't get that or wouldn't hear it, and maybe people wouldn't even care. I don't know. But, you know...
What did they say, Tami? What was some of the feedback you got?
Just that, I mean, I can't tell you verbatim, except that the feeling was just, oh, really? That's what you want to do with your life? Like, that's what's next for you? Like, you're going to give all of this up to do that, and then immediately you get put in the box of failure. And, you know, just falling below expectations, and you could have done so much, and what if, and that's just a hard place to be, you know? I mean...
So how did you deal with
thank
that?
Thank God there wasn't too much social media at the time.
If it was no, it wouldn't be a problem.
Yeah, thank God.
So how did you deal with it? I mean, obviously you would have surrounded yourself with family.
Yes, and you know what? Just moving through, and this is something that I think I've always done, is taking things one day at a time. Mm-hmm. And you know what else? I've always had this immense trust in God that the next thing would reveal itself. And I've always had this ability to be okay with not being the best or the greatest or whatever you think I should be. I've always had this like ability to be like, I'm good just being a regular, degular person. Mm-hmm. And I could always somehow see some beauty in that.
Yeah.
And I guess it's because you're on the other side of it sometimes and you see all of the flashy, but then, you know, I really saw the joy in the regular.
Yeah. Well, we're going to talk about the regular on the other side, because the regular came with marriage. Mm-hmm. It came with motherhood, mm-hmm. which you thought were things that were going to fill this, mm-hmm. you know, hole.
Void.
Maybe void.
Yeah.
Void.
Yeah.
And that too taught you a lesson.
Yeah, I think, you know, we go in search so much in other people to fill that void. Like, we're constantly looking to other people to fix us and to fill us up and to help us, or I shouldn't say help us, we are looking for other people to create our happiness. And I think it's like one of the things that like I learned through that process, through getting married, through having children, that it wasn't gonna be the thing that made me whole. Mm. Hard thing to like come face to face with, because everything tells you, mm-hmm. you complete me. You know, this is, you're my other half. And then when you have children, you hear everybody talking about, oh, my kids are my world. And, you know, I would never, and I always, you know, have a hard time with mommy sometimes, because yes, while that is true, we never really talk about the other part of it, which is that we still have to find ourselves.
We're going to talk about that part of it when we take this break. We'll be right back. More with Tami on the other side. Back with you, everybody. Tami was speaking before the break about marriage and motherhood and how she thought, as everybody has told her that, or had told her that it was going to be, you know...
The thing.
The thing that made you...
Complete.
That filled you up.
Yeah. And then everybody's thought. I think that's a dream we're sold as, especially women, you know? Do get married, have the children. That's what's going to make you feel whole. That's what's going to make you feel complete. That's what's going to make your life worth living. And, you know, when I got married, I was only 26. I can say only 26 now, because now I know how young 26 was.
Yes.
But at the time, I was a big woman, and you couldn't tell me nothing, right?
Right. But after hindsight is 2020.
Hindsight is 2020. Yeah. And, you know, while Wayne is such a wonderful husband and has been an incredible partner to me, and while I love my children so much and have found so much joy with them, the biggest thing for me was figuring that out on my own. And the biggest thing I could have done for my family, and I still continue to do every day, is figure out Tami's happiness first.
Yeah.
And realizing that that's not selfish, and it's not some luxury that I give myself. It's a necessity.
Because you say some days you love it and some days...
Some days I hate
it. You hate
it. Some days I have the hardest time with motherhood and wifehood. Is that a word? I don't know.
We just made it up, girl.
You know, it's true. I mean, but I just realized and I could only figure out my journey and what made me happy and completing myself before I could show up for anybody else.
Where did that take you? You told me when we spoke that you realized in all of this process that you kind of have to be broken to be mended.
Yeah.
So you went to a really
I think all of us we've all experienced brokenness. Now, it may not be as broken as your story or your story, but brokenness is brokenness.
Subjective.
And so we can all agree that it's one of the hardest things that you'd ever go through because it makes you question everything about your life, about who you are, what you are, why you're here. And sometimes it happens in front of everybody, but most times it happens behind closed doors on bathroom floors. And, you know, I've experienced even within my marriage, within the last 10 years, brokenness that was just unexplainable. And brokenness I thought that I would never see the end of, you know? But I truly now get it. And I think something else I said to you was that we can't grow in comfort. We cannot stretch ourselves. We cannot become better where we are.
Yeah.
We cannot, I was explaining to my goddaughter the other day, we can't become patient by sitting in perfect scenarios. Like, things have to come to test your patience for you to be patient, which is why I stopped praying for patience.
which is why now your journey is one of returning rather than becoming. Because people set our becoming expectations.
I do believe that. And, you know, I feel like in our 20s, you know, we're really searching for who we are. And I feel like in your 30s, and I'm on the latter part of my 30s, I feel like it's so much of this becoming. We're becoming so many things, and especially in the last 10 years, I mean, you better be becoming something good. You know what I mean? There's no glory in just becoming who you are and being who you are. Yeah. There's no celebration or fanfare for showing up as you are. And so becoming is not a victorious, glorious thing. It doesn't always look pretty. Becoming is gritty and dirty and it's
ugly and painful.
It is. So now, though, I feel like I'm in a returning and I feel like I'm getting back to me and the core of who I am and who I think God means for me to be.
Mm-hmm.
And it may not be glamorous and it may not be everything everybody expected, but it is me. And there's something really beautiful about returning to who you are. And I wish that was celebrated more, that it was okay for us as women to just return to who we are.
Yeah. A lot of that has to do with acceptance and love from the people who know you most.
And from yourself, too.
And from yourself.
Yeah.
But we did catch up with some of the people who know and love you most.
What?
So have a look at this, Missy.
No. You know, I'm proud of you. You know, you make me proud every day. You make me proud of the woman you are. Proud of the woman you're becoming. I can't really give you any big brother advice because little sisters don't like big brother advice all the time.
Tami, just want to say I'm super proud of you. I love you to pieces. And thanks for always sending me that good Jamaican food.
Tami, kudos to you for always just being really honest about being a working parent. And you've got a really great way of speaking the truth about life, but in such an entertaining way.
We just wanted to say how proud we are of you and all the things you've achieved, and looking forward to see what else you're going to achieve.
When we were younger, we were in a production of Little People and Teen Players Club, and they cast her as a phoenix. And she had to basically be hoisted up by these wires and rise from like the ashes after this great big scene of flames and smoke. And to this day, that's how I see Tami, as a phoenix. You know, she rises to every occasion and through every occasion. And every time she does, she becomes better, she becomes renewed. She's constantly renewing who she is and herself, and I'm so proud of her.
She treats me like one family. She, any problem, she'll hug you, she kiss you. That's a goodie. She's a mother.
I'm so proud of you. I'm so glad you chose me to be your mom. And I've enjoyed every single moment of you up until now, and intend to enjoy the rest of my life with you.
Tami, your dad loves you so much, and I know I don't have to tell you that. That's something that you know. All the best for the future.
Okay.
I must be the luckiest husband ever. I didn't realize that I got a bargain deal, a steal of a deal, because with every passing year, my wife has evolved into something new, into someone new, a better version of herself. I am overblessed to have Tami in my life.
Thanks, Sam. I love you so much. You've been like a mom to me. I appreciate everything that you've done for me. You're generous, you're kind, and you take care of all of us. And if it wasn't for you, I probably wouldn't be here today.
I love you, Mom. You're the best.
You are the best. You are amazing. You're loving. You take care of us. I love you so, 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 so much. I said that until I could come out of breath.
Baby sis, I love you.
We love you.
Love you.
Love you.
Thank you, my darling. I love you.
I love you. I look up to you.
Mwah. Thank you for loving us. We love you back.
We love you.
Ah, mash me up. I never expected. I wouldn't wear so much mascara if me knew.
I'm sorry, girl. I'm sorry.
Wow.
It feels good to be in your own skin and just have that kind of love, eh?
Yeah. Yeah. And you know, every single person you saw just now is so important to my becoming, my returning, and they just stand by me for whatever is next, you know, and they understand how I am and who I am. They're the people who have been with me my whole life, you know. And Alex, I can't believe you got Alex to say so much. I love him.
Oh, gosh.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
You're amazing.
Thank you, my friend.
And we have more.
Oh, man.
On the other side. Soon come.
Wow.
All right, welcome back to the show, everybody. Our final segment with Tami. We were talking a while ago about surrendering.
Yeah.
Why we, you know, I was saying to you, you make it sound so easy, and you said it's not hard.
It's not.
What does surrendering look like?
So I heard, I think it was Oprah once said, you know, we often think that surrender is almost a submission, almost a, you know, holding down, when surrender is really an opening up and a letting in and just being open to the possibility of life and to your purpose and to what that is, and being okay with it not being something grand or great. We hear purpose and we think it must mean, you know, some big thing. When I think, you know, your purpose is just to show up as you are. It doesn't mean you have to, it doesn't mean you can't stretch for more and reach for more and grow and change, but it's about allowing yourself to be right here, right now, as you are, and willing to grow and change from there, you know, as opposed to pretending to be something and then having to, you know, kind of circle back around to who you are and what you believe. And, you know, like we say, you know, sometimes, man, it takes so long to figure out how to love yourself and how to be there for yourself and show up for yourself. But you know what? These things happen right on time.
Yeah.
And it couldn't have happened before, no.
Agreed.
You know, and everything happens in that right time and with everything that happens in your life.
So let me ask you to look back at this chick, Lori, if you could put her up, and tell me what you would say to her, to that girl, about the future, about ending up where you are now, about avoiding some of the pitfalls and some of the struggle, speak to her and to the others who are that girl.
Oh, wow. I would say to her, I know you think you have it all figured out. I know. And I know that you think life looks a certain way. It's okay for you to let life surprise you. It's okay for you to feel how you feel. It's okay for you to be who you are. And it's okay that you don't know who that is. And it's okay that you don't have that figured out. You do not need to know everything right now. But I wouldn't necessarily like take her off track. I'd want her to go through every pitfall,
really?
Every heartbreak, every devastating
blow. You wouldn't change anything.
I wouldn't. Because it's necessary.
Yeah.
Like I said, you don't grow from ease. You don't grow from comfort. It's the same way with our kids. You know, we want to protect them from everything that happens. And it's actually the quickest way to stop them from learning how to do things like, simple things like walking. Imagine I was to try and pick up Oz every time he fell. Oh, no. He would never try and walk again. You know, I look back at when I was like her age and I think about my dad letting me out to go do things. And I'm like, how did you let me out of the house? I look at him now and I'm like, how did you let me out of the house, out of your sight? And he said something to me so beautiful. He said, I had to trust everything that I taught you.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what growing up is about. Mm-hmm. Trusting everything that we've learned. Trusting everything that's within us.
And then suddenly.
You know, I heard Jesse Royals saying once, and it made everything so clear to me, that fire was here long before the first person ever put two flintstones together. The knowledge of fire existed. It didn't cease to exist just because somebody didn't discover it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same for us. There's so much within you. It's already there. It's already there. It's just getting the two flintstones together, and it will happen. And your whole universe, your whole discovery is waiting to happen. Like, there are things within you that are waiting to be discovered, and just because you haven't seen the fruit of it doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
Gotcha. And this is why so many people watch you on YouTube. Yeah. Because, Tami, your gems are priceless, and it's obvious that you are speaking from lived and learned experiences, and we can all take. I mean, I'm being schooled tonight as much as anybody else, and I thank you for being here.
I thank you for having me, and I thank you for holding this space with people and creating this. This was just a thought in your head, and I feel like I'm sitting in one of your dreams, and to me, that's so remarkable, because not many people get to have those things come to fruition, and so I'm very proud of you, and I thank you on behalf of everybody who has found so much joy and peace within Sim Soul Sessions, that you just keep going, because there's so much inside of you. There is.
Thank you, Tam.
Thank you, my friend.
And now, all that's left for us to do is our affirmation.
Yeah. I love that.
Oh, gosh. That's not fair what you just said. So it is said that one of the greatest regrets in life is being who others wanted you to be and not yourself.
Mm.
Sometimes we try so hard to be what other people want, but life is too short to be anything but happy. Steve Jobs said it best when he said, our time is limited, so we shouldn't waste it living someone else's life. The journey to self-discovery is often hard and painful, but the fruits of that labor are absolutely priceless. It is that work which will eventually teach you that you alone, as Tami always says, you are enough, and that you have nothing to prove to anybody. It is that journey that teaches that it is what comes to you most naturally that really changes the world. If you've been criticizing yourself for years or listening to criticism from others, how about you try to accept and approve of yourself and see what happens? It's time to fight for your happiness, your fulfillment, knowing full well that others may be scoffing. Don't be mad at the experiences that shaped you. They are a part of your story. And if you've spent your life listening to others, stop for a little now and hear what your own voice is saying. What do you want? What do you want to do? What makes you happy? answering those questions can get you to that version of yourself that takes you to a place of freedom, of self-love, and contentment, and of owning who you are. So tonight we are affirming. Mrs. Chin Mitchell, if you can read that for me, please. It says,
beautifully flawed and all, I choose to be unapologetically fearless, authentically and bravely me.
Love it. Beautifully flawed and all, I choose to be unapologetically, fearlessly, authentically and bravely me. I want to be like this lady, goals in this chair. Thank you, Tami, for
thank
joining
you, my
us
friend.
Tonight. And thank you guys for joining me in our safe space. We will be back here next week with another amazing story of the power of the human spirit. Until then, every blessing to you. And please remember to count your blessings. Good night. Mm-hmm.